Thank you, Catherine. Well, this morning I'm joined by Dr. Frank Rhame, an infectious disease specialist with Allina Health. Doctor, thanks for being here this morning. Talk a little bit, first of all, what Catherine was just talking about, the CDC calling this an alert, the alert level that they've issued. Can you talk about that a little bit? What's that mean?
Well, they're basically saying for travelers, only necessary travel should be to the three heavily affected countries. And they're emphasizing travelers from those countries to here who are sick. So it's important to recognize that while this is a big problem, particularly in places where there's not good health care, here in the United States we have much better control of things, and transmission doesn't really occur from people who aren't sick. And with this illness, you get sick. I mean, there's no mild Ebola illness.
Sure.
So if you're around somebody who's sick, who's been in one of those places in the last 3 weeks, that's something to worry about, and that's something to get that person into a controlled circumstance fast. But otherwise, it's not a worry.
You don't think it's a worry here in the United States?
It's a worry if you're in that circumstance. So the trick for public health authorities is always to get the people who should be worried worried.
Sure.
And to keep the people who don't need to be worried from getting too anxious.
I mean, Ebola is something that has been around for a number of years. This is nothing new. It's just that this particular outbreak is new.
Well, this is a much bigger outbreak than it's ever been before, by a factor of five right now. And it shows no sign of stopping. Now, we're putting a lot more resources into those three countries now, so maybe we'll begin to turn the corner. But so far, the corner hasn't been turned there. But it's a vastly different place from the amount of control we can produce here.
I know we've done some stories about local organizations, local doctors who have been over there or who had to cancel trips because of this. I presume we're going to continue to see more of that happen as well.
Yeah, and I predict we'll see importations into this country from those places. I don't think we'll see transmissions from people who get into hospitals quickly.
So sick people will come here, but the sick people who come here won't make other people sick?
As long as we get them into a controlled circumstance fast. So the thing to emphasize is, if you've been in one of those places, or if you're caring for somebody who's been in one of those places who's sick, get that person into isolation quickly.
And quickly before you go, the things to look out for, we're talking severe fever, vomiting, nausea, those things.
Right, exactly. So it isn't really very specific until they get the bleeding manifestations, which they don't always get. But they're sick. So it's sick. They just feel terrible. You know, they've got headache and fever and nausea and diarrhea and vomiting. Not very specific, but they are sick.
Sure. Well, doctor, we appreciate your time today. Thanks for stopping by. We'll, of course, folks, keep you updated. The latest on this Ebola outbreak on our website. You can always catch it online at kstc45.com.